What's up, y'all? It's your boy Eric, and welcome to the video. So right now, I'm at Korea University in my dorm, which is called CJ International, a dorm for all international students. And right now, I'm pretty down bad. Not pretty down bad, I'm very down bad. So the whole time before we arrived in Korea, they were telling us they were giving us sheets and pillows. What they gave us last night at 9:30 p.m. was this Korea University throw blanket. It doesn't smell bad, but this is not a sheet. This is just a blanket. And it's super thin. And on top of that, the heater was broken. This is exactly what I want to sleep in. A Sherpa jacket, a fleece, and a long sleeve t-shirt. Your boy got two pairs of pajamas on. And I damn near went to sleep with my socks on. But, you know, you can't do that. If you sleep with your socks on, exit the video. And no pillows. Your boy was sleeping like a plank yesterday. But on that note, I'm done complaining because right now, it's about 9:45 in the morning. I slept in, I have pretty good energy right now. So I'm gonna head to Daiso, which is like the dollar store slash Walmart over here. I really don't know how to explain it because they don't really have a counterpart. It's like a Five Below and a Target. I'm gonna go there and try to clean my room up, make everything look nice. Cause right now I have a 7-Eleven bag for a trash can. I have a vacuum bag for a hamper. And overall, my stuff is just everywhere. And hopefully when we come back and I have some time to clean up, my room will look much better. So make sure to watch until the end to see a quick room transformation. It's not gonna be done completely. It's only the second day here, technically first full day. So we're gonna get it to look as good as possible. Yeah, so basically the bathroom and the shower. Basically two holes in the wall. They're not connected. Shower experience is very, very unique. Never had to take a shower like this before, where the shower isn't like in a room other than the shower itself. But that being said, get used to everything after a while, so. Okay, so right outside the door, I made a new friend from the Netherlands.
Hello!
And we're gonna go get breakfast right now, because I was supposed to eat anyways. I'm super hungry. Hello, I'm a stranger. We got Russia. Everybody here is Russian.
Russian?
Russian. American? Netherlands. So right now we're at the bus stop. It's my first time taking the bus, but swimming to the train, it goes one way or the other, so it shouldn't be too bad. So basically we kind of took the wrong bus, but since we're exploring, there's no such thing as a wrong bus or wrong anything. So once again, a lot of things are just random. And yeah, wow, this view is amazing. And the city is just crazy because of all the mountains that it's built on, but also all the mountains that surround it.
Whoa, whoa, yeah, yeah, yeah. Look at your rollie, look at my rollie. That's a smart face, this a big face. She can't see my room, fuck her in the hallway. Getting bored with this money, count it all day. Yeah, they thought we were soft, boy, you learn the hard way.
So I've had a streak of eating samgyeopsal. I think it's been 2 days, 3 days in a row. There's no English on this, but I think I'm gonna go for it anyways. It's looking like some spicy beef with fried rice, hopefully. So right now they're all getting T-money cards, which you can just buy at the convenience store. You can also reload them here and use them to pay at the convenience stores, which is pretty cool, pretty advanced for a subway card. All right, so I also just put some money on my T-card and then I used it to pay for the gimbap.
On the south side of town, getting me a ball fade. Pass us some stuff, we can down in all take. No, can't trust her, she gon' leave us all lace. Bust the bankroll in the club where she's like, whoa.
Yeah, they got the fish right on the block. Mad fish, just right outside, and that's how they promote their products. I've seen that a lot over here in Korea. Pretty interesting because it's a restaurant, I believe. It's not a supermarket. All right, so I also used my T-Money card inside this pair of spaghetti, which was pretty cool. So it actually is very, very versatile. And 안녕하세요. I scared the fuck out of this lady. Oh my God, she literally moved away from me. I can get used to this.
This looks amazing. I've never had a soup come out to me in a hot plate and it's boiling still.
All right, so I'm finally back outside. It's starting to warm up just a little bit. Your boy's wearing two pairs of pants right now. The winters over here are pretty harsh, but I'm lucky because the Daiso is only 4 minutes away from where I was just eating. So I'm gonna be there in just a second. So right now I'm finding a bunch of things I didn't even know I needed. It's tough because most of the stuff I'm gonna probably have to throw away or give away because I can't bring it back to the States. And yeah, that's the thing that's tough about studying abroad. Everything just costs money basically. It's whether you just want to spend the money and buy it or not. All right, Daiso trip, successful, pretty much. But yeah, I didn't know I was gonna leave with this much stuff. I literally have a yoga mat sticking out of my backpack right now. I'll see you guys at the dorm and I'll let you guys know exactly what I bought and how much it costs. Honestly, I didn't even check myself. I just gave her my card. So I'm hoping it's not too much.
Okay, so now that I'm a little more settled in, let's see what we got from Daiso and how much it ended up costing me. First things first, we got the TP, the toilet paper. That's 100% a necessity. And then we have this, which is some bubble hand soap. Next thing I got was this double-sided tape because I'm gonna be putting up some of my pictures that I printed out. It's called Organic Cherry Blossom Conditioner. The shampoo. And then we have a travel adapter. Then we have this. This was giving me a little trouble. This is just some detergent. It comes in a bag over here. And also, this was the main reason why I had to go to Daiso today, because I think I'm on my last pair of underwear. I can't even lie to y'all. And then I bought two packs of these. These are command strips. One, two, three. We also have this. Yeah, I love the random quotes they put on these things. Lovely days. This is one of things to do on your today's to-do list. That was hard to read. This is one of things to do on your today's to-do list. I brought an empty backpack so I could bring stuff back. And have a good amount of stuff in here too. So I think this was my best buy, honestly. 5,000 won for this yoga mat. But they have Kleenex here, I guess. With a really cute dinosaur figure, a really cute bunny and dinosaur figure. I guess they're in love. Doesn't stop there. Yep, one more. $1.50. Then I have this, which is looking like Korean Tide. Next, we have this. This is just a bath mat. It was 5,000 won. And then last but not least, this was also another reason why I wanted to go. These hangers. There were so many options of hangers. Like, I want to say 10 to 15 different options, ranging in price. So I ended up going with the two cheapest ones, which is 6 metal hangers for 1,000 won. And then I also opted in for these more expensive ones. These are super thick, so I'm going to put my nicer clothes on here so they don't get all stretched out. And these were 5 for 2,000 won. But the total for all of this stuff was 55,500 won, which is about $50. That's pretty lit. I'm not gonna lie, 50 bucks for all this stuff, especially since I came with a yoga mat and the shampoo. Those are the most expensive things, and detergent and toilet paper. Those are all expensive things.
So I promised you guys a quick room tour / room transformation. So here it is. This is what my room looked like after shopping, and it looked crazy. I looked like I was hoarding. Fast forward a little bit, and this is what my room looks like now. It may look like things are everywhere, but there's a reason for everything. So now for the closet, this is where I have all my clothes, and I definitely brought way too much, but you gotta be dripped for all occasions, even in Korea. And in the drawers, I have, yep, more clothes. And then the one below that, I have all of my shoes. And then on the other side, I have my pants and these suitcases. And this is actually two suitcases. One of them is just stuffed in the other. And that's something that you need if you're going abroad, especially in Korea. The rooms aren't that big, so you have to save some space by stacking the suitcases. So now for the suite tour, right outside my door, I have the floor mat. You already know I needed that. Can't be coming out the shower, stepping onto nothing but the bare floor. And just to update on the shower situation, I'm super used to the shower and bathroom because it turns out it's actually pretty convenient because since the sink, the bathroom, and the toilet are all disconnected, I basically have access to the shower and the bathroom and I can brush my teeth whenever I want. And in college, two people to a shower and a bathroom is super rare, but when they're separate, that's even better. And to explain the suite in total, this is basically a four-person suite, and each of us have a single. And the setup is basically symmetrical, so me and my roommate share this side, and my other two suite mates share the other side. And in between, there's this huge common room, which is super key, and it's super valid because now I have enough space to work out. And this amount of space is also super rare in a college suite. And this common room actually has more space for us to put our things in, and I'm utilizing my section of this cabinet. But it's kind of funny because my suite mates haven't touched theirs. And that's also the reality of studying abroad. You're not going to really bring that much. And to end this quick tour off with a bang, the only thing that was in my room when I got here was these guys. And if you guys are seeing what I'm seeing, then we're probably on the same page. And you should definitely subscribe because I feel like not everyone's going to see it. But I definitely see something. But just to end this video off, shopping at Daiso, which is the dollar store over here, is a reality if you're studying abroad over here for a semester like I am. Because it just doesn't feel right to spend a bunch of money on quality products when I'm literally just gonna have to throw it away. I know I mentioned that before, but it's just way too wasteful. But the beautiful thing about Korea is that the dollar store over here is pretty quality. You do get what you pay for. Literally, what I'm sitting on right now is memory foam, but the memory part of it's missing because... But you see, this thing was only like $3 and it's better than nothing. Same with this lamp. When I first got here, it was way too dark, but I went to Daiso, bought this lamp for $5. It's not very bright, but once again, you get what you pay for, and it's better than nothing. And it's better than spending, let's say, $25 on a lamp that works well, but then you're just gonna have to leave it here because you're not gonna have any space to bring anything home other than the stuff that you came with, plus souvenirs, extra clothes that you bought, you know, all those little things. You're not going to care about a lamp. And also, since I'm here for such a short amount of time, the motivation to get my room really nice is pretty low. But personally, I think this room is pretty nice. It's much better compared to my freshman year of college, where I went to college, did not bring any pictures, any memorabilia. My room was just literally blank. And that definitely made me feel homesick. So my tip to anyone that's studying abroad is to obviously bring pictures, bring memorabilia of friends back home, and to decorate your room as well as you can. My room is basically decorated, as you guys saw before, with food products. I realized that I really shouldn't have that much food in my room, so I actually ended up bringing it out into the hallway, into that little cabinet that I have. Because after I was filming shots in my room, I was like, why do I have so much food over here? Why do I have 2 packs of pasta, some sauce, Nutella, peanut butter? And that's the beauty about making YouTube videos. I get to reflect and look at things from a different angle, and that made me realize that it's not really smart to have that much food near me. Drop any questions you have in the comments, and I'll answer all of them, because the reason I made this video is because I know people are super curious about the living spaces over here and how to kind of deal with all the problems that come with studying abroad. And this is one of the realities. You gotta shop at the dollar store for all dorm necessities, which is okay because you're not gonna be here for too long. So don't stress out about that too much and use me as your resource, because I'm literally in Korea right now in a dorm that you could possibly live in if you're going to KU. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next video. Peace out.